Hello there, YouTube. It's welcome back to Austria-Hungary in the Great War mod for Hearts of Iron 4. We're doing another stream, as you may have guessed, because, you know, Twitch chat is up. I'm pointing the right way for once. I normally always point like that way, and then I'm like, ah, that's wrong. I forget my camera, like, flip stuff. So, we are starting our first focus based on the Balkan War. I don't know if this will actually make us go to war or not, so I'm just going to, like, hopefully be ready for it. But everyone else is a little bit distracted right now. Can I, like, extend this because you're part of the same league? No. Okay, let's select 8. New front line. There we go. Now, we should have a pretty easy way into Belgrade because it's right next to us. Sing? Why should I sing? Why should I sing? Like, because it's like a new episode or something? Ottoman Empire joined the Second Balkan War. Oh, following the start of the Second Balkan War, the Ottoman Empire decided to take advantage of the situation to reclaim some of their lost lands. Bulgaria is going to get owned. Poor Bulgaria. This is where we attack from the rear. I mean, it's the best way to attack, to be honest. I mean, it's accurate because we're starting World War II, but, you know, that's exactly what I'm focusing on, right? I'm entirely going for... Wait, I build these manually. Oh, is it forts that are here? Yeah, okay, these are actually genuine land forts, okay. Not trenches. We're going to build some genuine trenches ourselves. Just over here to protect us a little bit from Italy. And I probably will want more military factories as well. Actually, I think military factories have probably come first. Right, research slot. 1914, we can do all the 1914 stuff. So, give me improved infantry equipment. Stage a coup. I mean, I have got the influence, but I can't really coup anyone who's authoritarian. Oh, we could coup France. Maybe we should coup France. Stage a coup. We can make them go fascist. They'd be the first fascist nation. We can make them go communist, but that's not particularly great for us. They are, like, leaning communist anyway, though. I'm trying to think who we'd want to coup. Like, who would you want to coup in this situation? Because we can't coup people to be authoritarian. Like, would we want to really coup anyone to be fascist? Sure, we'll try it with France. Just, it probably won't be that effective, but we'll try it because lol. Can you make Germany communist? I mean, I guess I could. $61.23 from Kasuja. Evie to the battle. Thank you very much, Kasuja. That's very kind of you. Thank you so much. Right, let's go get Evie. Hello. Evie will be helping with the First World War. Let's see if I can actually get Evie. Come on. There we go. That is not precarious at all and totally not going to knock over my cider. Evie deserves a hat. Evie has got a hat. Like, have you not seen Evie's hat? Evie has an EnterElysium hat. Evie needs a... Okay, well, let's get Evie a hat. There we go. This is totally not going to work. I need to put something, like, heavy to, like, weigh down Evie to make sure Evie doesn't fall off. Wait, there we go. Wedge the hat in there. And that's totally how you wear a hat. This is, okay, let's just be honest. This is not going to work. Why am I even bothering? There we go. That does not look comfortable for Evie. Ah. Totally works. Yeah, that hat is pretty amazing. Alright, got technology we need to research. Let's grab Earthly Motorized. Why not? How long till we're ready for our first Balkan? Ooh. 20 days. Still no support equipment. Field gun was still down on. Support equipment's the main one. Plunge more nations in civil war. Not going to cost 800, like, political power. That is crazy amounts. First, ooh, hello. I don't know what it actually did, but it did something, I'm sure. Thank you, Pony7! People should hail Eevee more, to be honest. Ooh, investigate Serbian expansionism. Gain diplomatic malice. Gain blah, 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 blah. Gain Ottoman Empire likes me more. Or send military advisors. Bulgaria likes me more. Okay, so either get Serbia to hate me. I can do both, actually. But none of these allow me to actually go to war, which is annoying. Well, I guess we'll investigate Serbian expansionism. Don't go motorized. With horse-drawn carriages, you're also bringing food to the front if you run out of rations. Ko, you make a very good point there. You make a very, very good point. Oh. Serbia, White Peace, Bulgaria. Treaty of Bucharest. A treaty concluded in the aftermath of the Second Balkan War and amended the Treaty of London, which ended the First Balkan War. Bulgaria signed a separate border treaty with the Ottomans, who had regained some territory west. Okay, I'll be honest. My first feeling is I'm not a massive fan of these events forcing history to go a certain way. I think it's an alternate history game. And this is kind of forcing history to always happen in a certain way. So far. And I don't really have anything to do with Austria-Hungary. I think it should be more left up to, you know, the game to decide what happens. You can always force, you know, diplomatic circumstances to happen a certain way or whatever. By altering the AI's diplomacy ideas. Still a great mod, don't get me wrong, but that's my only criticism so far. Division defense or entrenchment? I'm gonna go for division defense. I'm still at 31% war score. I want more war score! Must get rid of Germany and France. I mean, you know. One thing first, right? War score's at the war tension. What's it? World tension is actually ticking down. This is bad. Give me more world tension. Let's grab motorized ambulances. Like, I'm guessing we wait for September for Andrew, for Franz Ferdinand to be, like, shot by an ostrich, right? Oh, June, okay. Franz Ferdinand, the esteemed Archduke of Austria and Crown Prince of Austria-Hungarian Empire, lies dead. His noble wife rests beside him. Franz Joseph has lost another heir, and to the damn vile sons of the bastards of the Serbians. The Serbian government officially denies the involvement of the assassin Gavrilo Princip, blaming the Black Hand, although few believe the lack of government involvement. We've sent compensation demands to the Serbians. If they decline, they'll have hell to pay. They'll all pay! Well, they've got a choice now. Fortify the Dalmatian coast. Nah. Build airports near Russia. Nah. I can't do Second Balkan War because it didn't even give me a chance. That was... I don't know if it's meant to happen that fast, but there's no way I can go through that tree that fast. Let's get the ability to send military advisors. I'm guessing an event will make me go to war now. 35% war tension. It's not enough for me to actually do anything. First, I loaded Crown Prince is shot by some hot-headed anarchist. I was going to say architect. Yeah, architect. Say it sounds like everyone. Then the Serbians, emboldened by their ties to Russia, decline our list of very simple and reasonable demands for compensation. They weren't, but so be it. If Serbia will not accept Austrian rule in Bosnia and will fire off any government official until the spoiled brats get their way, then Austria will simply extend rule over their own territory and ensure... So basically, declare war. Okay, we're on. Ah! This is what happened. This is why the First World War was so crazy. Welp. I guess we're going. Apples. Oh well, front line. And then offensive line. And also do it. I'm gonna move you to the Russian board for the moment. And I think, yeah, we should go for an immediate push because the Russians actually haven't got very much. So we're gonna try and go for this river as our defensive point. Okay, over here, we'll just stay with a few troops. Welcome. Maintain that. Gip, 14 months, thank you very much. Kiev, Warsaw, maybe eventually get Minsk. That's the plan for today. Air wings with no missions. Airship and close air support. Do it. We need more lumber. Not getting it from Russia anymore. We could try getting it from German Empire. 1914, from the unspeakable other, Papa Nurgle. Walter says hi.
Walter says hi.
Thank you very much, Papa Nurgle. Papa Nurgle presides. Who else can I get, like, lumber from? Anyone close by? Bulgaria! Thank you very much. I'm down for that. Serbia refuses Austrian demands. Don't we know that already? Pretty sure we know that. I mean, that's why we're going to war, right? I'm actually getting more than I need. So I'm going to cancel mine with Germany for now. Mongolia's been called in. Belgium has joined. France is no longer sending us. Right. Germany, you send us steel, please. There's a lot of steel to import. Oh, we are not doing well here. Why is that? That's more divisions. Oh, wow. We need a lot of artillery. Suddenly, we need a lot of artillery. Damn. Okay. Still need more wood. Very well. Please get me more wood. Empire of Japan is just fine against us. Japan's just fine against us. Now, I can actually declare on places because I have the world tension. However, kind of busy right now. Jean Juarez of France assassinated in the Parisian cafe Le Croissant by the aptly named Raoul Villain, a 29-year-old French nationalist. Okay. Well, fair enough. Not much I can do about that, so I'm just going to make that disappear. What can we do over here? We can go to war economy, total mobilization, actually reduces recruit population. Go to war economy. We'll go down to limited export. I'll go to export focused. Maybe. Limited exports and export focused. We'll go to limited exports. And we will up ourselves to extensive conscription. Oh, we can't do that. Get rid of political power. Fair enough. Then if we check our import screen, should be fine without any imports. Just. How goes the war effort? Black Sun, the war effort goes okay-ish, although, surprising enough, we're actually losing ground to Serbia. That was not appreciated, I'll be honest. They have 300 fighters. We have 3. Maybe we should have been focusing a little bit more on air power. I kind of just assumed that, you know, air power in this era, not really a massive thing. And maybe we should grab a couple of units from over here. And we'll send them to the Russian front for now. Early motorized. Excellent. Anything else we can grab 1914-ish? I mean, we can grab all of these. Engineering company sounds like a good bet. And we will upgrade our production. Rubber. Okay, we're actually going to need to import rubber. The Netherlands is the only person who will actually give us rubber. Oh, this is going to be difficult. Netherlands, please stay on our side. Please stay on our side. We're still... God damn it, because we're promoting stuff over here. How close are we to finishing? Okay, we can keep going. Opening the Panama Canal. Lovely. Right, Russia's getting its butt owned. What are we lacking at the moment? Support equipment? Yeah. That'll hopefully be sorted soon. There are choices to reduce the amount of support equipment we need. I kind of think we need to do that. Send military advisors. Awesome. At war. The focus will cancel the recruitments. Right. These give cause to Poland. So basically risks Poland being awesome. What do I want to do? I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do. Get a buffer artillery. Sure. Rush the overtraining divisions. Yeah, the thing to do, like I can just deploy them. Or I could just try and fix issues with, like, right now we're having some issues with actually having enough logistics to carry this out. So, for instance, I get rid of support artillery. I've actually got 2 artillery here, so I can temporarily get rid of that. get rid of, say, logistics company or something, maybe, or field hospital. And that will save some effort as well. Yeah, I'm going to do that. And we should get a load of resources suddenly free themselves up. Not enough, actually. How much do we need? A lot. Yeah, I think we just have to deploy them. You're right. Force deploy. Get them to the front line. They're just going to have to train on the job. Motorized ambulance. Which is this company. Bomber sighting, excellent. Aerobombs, sure. Not that we're actually going to have a chance to massively use this. We don't actually have any air support. Oh, fine, we'll work on our scouts. Actually, let's not do that, because I think scouts might actually become useless. Let's check. Air. Yeah, my guess is they become useless. I don't think they descend. We need to start doing research of that as well. Belgium's called the Empire of Japan in. Okay. That makes sense. Specific encirclement. Lovely. I much prefer it to that random encirclement you get. We actually got Belgrade almost encircled. Romania! The long rule of Carol I of Romania helped the quick development of Romanian state. During his reign, he led Romanian troops during the Russo-Turkish War and assumed command of the Russo-Romanian army during the siege of Pavia. Okay. Fair enough. Sounds like a bit of a dude. How are all those new troops faring up? They're actually getting there. Can take Russia out of the war. So we capitulated! Yes! Right, am I at war with anyone else here? Let's just quickly check. No. Romania has a very bad opinion. Ooh. Ooh, they do. They do not like us. Well, let's make sure we get that encirclement going. So far, it's working wonders. Montenegro capitulated. I need political power to actually start claiming on people, which is annoying. Right, well, I guess we need a few more guns, maybe. Maybe another early motorized. Navy, I need better troops. My troops are pretty amazing. I just need to be able to have the stuff to, like, power them. And then I'm going to put some of these troops over here. I'm going to replace you with a field marshal. And eventually want to go to war with Romania as well. Right. Group up, right click to all coastal submarines, we'll put you into a new group. And then we will select you. And I can get you to do convoy raiding around here. We get the coastal submarines to help out around there. The fires of revolution burn! Vichy France declared war on France. Really? Really, that's Vichy France. I'm a little bit disappointed, I have to say. I was expecting a little bit more. Yes, we will have a non-aggression pact, Vichy France. I really can't afford to lease lend you. We can focus on Russia in the winter, there'll be no problems. No problems whatsoever. Right. Got the artillery effort. Fortify the Dalmatian coast, we can go military harmonization. All of you are killed. It happens. Why do I even bother? 800 military power for that. 800 political power. That was useless. Absolutely. Absolutely useless. Trash tier event. Okay, we'll start thinking about that soon. I did have Zeppelins, JMFs. I had three. They died. Ottoman German alliance is ratified. Excellent. The Ottoman Empire is now with us. Let's surround them. They've got an armored car there. That's not allowed. Right, come on, we get a surround on. Look at all those RAF biplanes. I gotta admit, these new models are pretty funky. I like them. That's a nice bit of detail right there. Ooh, okay. Yeah, more military factories. I'm kind of waiting for that event where, like, Italy is going to help out and I'm going to really hate them. Free dockyards. I don't have free military factories. People tell me I've got free military factories. I don't. I've got free dockyards. We're going to need... Dreadnought. Yeah. Gonna build myself a dreadnought. We'll also build submarines somewhere else, just so they're separate. Yeah. All our coastal submarines are gone. Because Japan sent over destroyers. We got Warsaw. That's what I wanted. We got Warsaw. I'm happy. Independence guaranteed by people I'm already at war with. Oh no! Let's justify a goal. I'd like Moldavia. To actually try and actually complete that, that's going to be a pain in the ass. But we'll do our best. Right, let us add... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll train you till we get to like 3 or something. Support equipment. Oh, well, place them. ...1915 now. Ooh, there is extra industry. We can do it 1916. 1916. 1915. Poison gas. Breakthrough 12%. Totally worth it. And I was researching tank technologies. Ooh, also awesome. Yeah, they're going to take all my Pacific possessions. I'm not pleased about that, Chaos Lord. I like my Pacific possessions. Not that they're actually that important, but we'll see. Well, not sorry. Germany's. They're not mine, are they? No, Germany's. I keep forgetting I'm Austria-Hungary rather than Germany. Republic of China. Why are you democratic? You should be authoritarian. Come on, join me. Join me! The push towards Kiev is going well. I challenge Romanian pretensions. They do not know how strong our hardships have made us. At least there'll be an end to this conflict. Okay, we're attacking Kiev now. It's going okay. 54. We must rally behind this cause. Missing, what are we missing? Close air support. Oh yeah, no, it's fine. Don't worry about it. We'll deal with that some other time. Oh, we can encircle them. This entire bit here will be encircled and killed. Let's do that. You, quick, run up here. Help with the encirclement. Come on, I want Kiev. I want to get the victory points. I want to be, you know, the one in charge of these.
Welcome to the Empire. Stay shiny.
Double the door. 12 months. Thank you much. Balls. There we go. Right. You. And you. One of you goes here. One of you goes here. That's the last we speak of that. In fact, there's actually like one down here that needs to be defended as well. Oh, God. Right, let's grab another two people. Not you, you're important. You. There we go, you're less important. One of you goes here. One of you goes... Oh, God, there's another one as well. Here. You. You're here. Defend that. I don't want that happening again. National focus. Right, let's try that again. Fortify the Dalmatian coast. Research slot. We'll start working on the armored car, I guess. I don't know. Oh, no, we can do tank prototype, can't we? Yeah. Let's prototype some tanks, yeah. We also need to do more support equipment because we, like, are drastically low on that stuff. Daniel, I come back after 30 minutes and suddenly a Pokemon's invaded. What's going on? Yeah, it's... Oh, German Zeppelin campaign. It's interesting. It's unlikely the German troops will be able to reach the British mainlands in the current situation. However, our Zeppelin bomber balloons will be able to take the strike to the heart of British industry from afar. They may send their pathetic little fighter planes to try and strike them down. It's unlikely they'll be able to come close in altitude. This will show John Bull our might. Cole! Thank you for subscribing. Shall I try and pronounce your name again? Colodat. Co, thank you for subscribing. Welcome to the Empire. Right, the push on Germany's going well. Portugal's been... to be fair, that is like the longest standing alliance, I think, in the world? Portugal, United Kingdom? I think it still exists today. Let's push for Minsk. Oh, only one unit was actually available to push Minsk. Yeah, like, they're sabotaging all that down there because I'm not guarding it, but I'm a bit busy right now. We could make a unit specifically designed. Right. Let us edit, duplicate, MPs. Remove. Military police. Remove. Save. We'll train you. We'll train like 24. For now. And then, oh, you also get the reserves tag. After Russia, I'm going to take the Ottomans. The Ottomans are kind of in factions, so they'll have to wait. We've got many other enemies to face, though. Right, and with that, we can enact Plan Yellow, which doesn't sound as awesome as it really should, which is our plan for an assault on Romania. I'm also going to try and outflank Germany so I control his territory, because I'm a good ally. I keep questioning their sovereignty. Going well. You should always question their sovereignty. Every day, every night. Sometimes, you know, twice a night at least. There we go. That should simplify this front as well. And we can now add you to here. You should also get yourself a general. Oh, hello. Level 7. Very nice. Right, let's give you an offensive line. Frankly, the order should just be to, like, try and grab that. Yeah, that seems like a good plan. Have I ever lost a game of this, or have we never seen it? I don't think I've ever lost a game of it, but then again, like, you know. There have been a few times when it's got close, like my game of Denmark, where I held the line against Germany for like a year and a half. That was iffy. There was the Indian game where I owned Central Russia, and I actually lost a little bit of ground before being able to push back. That was iffy as well. Those were good games. Those I enjoyed. Modify government. What are we going to change? Conscription to extensive? We don't need to just yet. Military High Command. Division attrition decrease. Cavalry upgrades and stuff. I mean, that's all good. I'm going to go for the division attrition decrease. That's really helpful. All right, how long until we have our claim? June. So 2 months. There's another Hearts of Iron Trump video coming out in about 20 minutes over on the main channel. I believe we start plotting against Iran in this one. That's ahead of time, but frankly, I think it has to be ahead of time. So we'll start grabbing that ahead of time. If you're going to grab something ahead of time, a research buff's always a decent one to go for. Fortify the Dalmatian coast, finally, and that means we can do military harmonization. We get research bonuses for land, naval, and air doctrines. Which is just gravy. Hejaz! Ooh, capitulated. Goodbye, these are dark times. Not that I really care that much. Alright, Germany just has to hold out against the Allies for long enough. I can take on Russia. Oh no, 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 no! Don't get involved in that whole German shtick. No, definitely not. Austrian lands only. Oh! Is someone thinking about capitulating? Or has it frozen? Soviet Russia declare war on the Russian Empire. Tsar Nicholas abdicates. Demonstration that forced the poor Tsar into official abdication. Soviet Russia is now a thing. Which we are not going to get involved with just yet. We might go communist. It's tempting just to screw up everything. Romania joined the Entente. Of course they would. They're afraid of getting attacked. Not that it really helps. I'm more at war with them. Mongolia joined the White Movement. That sounds a little bit racist. I know it's historical, but whatever. And Romania's been called into the war. Okay, I did not expect that, but sure. I don't need to do my thing anymore, which I'm not doing. Cool. Okay. Right. We got this. You can attack. You, however, you are actually worrying. You're outgunned. Construction. Yeah, we're going to probably need to make sure we get, like, full-on trenches up here. I don't think I can take out Italy until I finish with everyone else. Both Russias must be destroyed. I mean, I want to, but I'm not sure if that'll be possible because the game is very heavily scripted. Or at least this mod is. So I'm not sure. I'll see. I'll try. I will try my best. United States have been called in. And that's going to be a problem. Non-aggression pact from the Soviet Union. They have a non-aggression pact with your faction leader. Can stage a coup. I'm not taking it. We might go fascist. We might go communist if they do. How are we doing down here? Well enough. Actually not well enough. I need a few forces to come and help. One too many. Don't fight into the hard places, attack the soft places. Do they know nothing? We also need to get this tank thing up and rolling, like, as soon as possible. It's gonna be a while. You're feeling a bit better about yourself, so I'm going to actually start moving over a couple of troops over here, and I'm going to flip you for a field marshal. Yeah, I think we're going to have to end the YouTube episode pretty shortly. Like, I think it's gone very long for this one, which I don't mind. This war's been very interesting so far. We're going to need all the forces we can get over here. But, yeah, that's a good place to leave it. So, I've been at Elysium. If you've enjoyed, like and subscribe and all that jazz. And yeah, Twitch. Say goodbye to YouTube. YouTube, Twitch. I'm gonna wait for the like little messages to appear. Yeah, the Russian Civil War can totally kick off in 1915, right? That's totally fair. Oh yeah, we need a new attack plan on the Russian front soon. I'm gonna try and get Crimea when we've pushed that little bit in the bottom, but we should be good to push onwards. The problem with Soviet Russia, I'm not sure where it leaves us standing. Like, I'm afraid that the event might go, okay, cool, Soviet Russia took over, so the entire Russia front is kind of abandoned, and yeah, everything's cool. When I'm like, actually, I kind of want to keep my winnings. Thank you very much. But historically, it'd be like, oh yeah, you just can't take on Russia at the same time. It's like, no, it's really in the war. I can totally take on Russia. Anyway, goodbye, YouTube, and until next time, stay shiny.